Welcome, Qiskitters. I'm excited to tell you about Qiskit Runtime, which was built to make it easier for you to create powerful algorithms and run them at scale. Qiskit Runtime is a programming model and containerized execution environment for deploying quantum programs launched by IBM quantum developers last year. In this video, I'll overview what I mean by that and how to get started with Qiskit Runtime. Start by navigating to the Qiskit Runtime overview on Qiskit.org, as I already have. Qiskit Runtimes is an extension of Qiskit that allows scalable and efficient execution of quantum programs over the cloud. Instead of submitting jobs to an API, Qiskit Runtimes involve primitive programs that run circuits based on your desired output. The runtime is managed in an environment containing all the necessary Qiskit libraries and is run nearby the quantum hardware to reduce latency, providing substantial speedup for a large class of algorithms that require feedback loops between classical and quantum hardware. Currently, two kinds of primitives, or predefined programs, are available for the initial release of Qiskit Runtime. The sampler is much like the counts typical users of Qiskit would be familiar with. They are normalized by the number of shots taken and possibly involve error mitigation, which is why the outputs of the sampler are called quasi-probabilities. The estimator officially calculates expectation values of quantum operators, such as those used in the variational quantum eigensolver for computing molecular properties. The connection between Qiskit and Qiskit Runtime is helpfully answered by this Qiskit blog post. We have a link in the description below. This figure provides a good summary. First, build your circuits with Qiskit as usual. Next, choose the primitive program to execute your circuits depending on the output you want. The sampler returns quasi-probabilities that are related to counts. The estimator returns expectation values useful for VQE. There are currently two channels for accessing Qiskit Runtime services. The IBM Cloud provides free simulator access and paid access to premium systems. The IBM Quantum Platform gives access to the same systems you have via your usual IBM Quantum provider. Either of these channels then handles the orchestration and execution of quantum jobs on the IBM Quantum systems. Let's take a look at how to use both channels. Navigate back to Qiskit.org and click on Getting Started. In addition to installing Qiskit, which we covered in a previous video, you'll need to do a pip install Qiskit IBM Runtime inside your working Python environment. Let's set up our servers for both IBM Quantum and IBM Cloud. Start by opening a Jupyter Notebook or Python interpreter, and then copy the code from the Getting Started page, as I already have done. Load the Qiskit Runtime service. And first, let's save our IBM Quantum account. This API token is the same one we set up in the user install video. Let's retrieve our IBM Quantum token. Copy your API key and paste it inside the token. That saves our IBM Quantum account info locally, so we can get rid of the cell for security. Now copy the code for saving an IBM Cloud account and get started with the IBM Cloud. Click on Retrieve IBM Cloud Token. Either log in or create an account. As you can see, I already have one. We first need to create a service instance. We can choose the free light plan or paid standard plan. Read and agree to the following license agreements and create the instance. Here we need to copy our cloud resource name or CRN and paste it back in our cell. Next, go to the API Keys page to copy your relevant IBM Cloud API key. If you don't have one, you can create one here. And paste back in the cell. Now we've saved our IBM Cloud account info, so we can delete this cell for security as well. To check that everything worked out nicely, copy the test code in our notebook and run. And we're good. Now that everything is set up, let's get started with the primitives. Go on to the tutorials page. We'll start with a sampler primitive, but I'll run these locally on my laptop. We've already prepared the environment, so this will show how to use the sampler primitive. This works by starting a session, by sending circuits to the runtime, then the concept of a job is defined as a collection of iterative calls to the runtime. Two program inputs must be put in, the circuits you wish to run, and any parameters contained in those circuits. You have the option of specifying a backend or to skip transpilation. Start by loading the runtime service in sampler and create a bell circuit. The session executes all the code in a block, and exits when the block is over. Running the job and returning the results are done by writing to and reading from the session. Initialize the session by passing the circuit we wish to run, just a single circuit without parameters in this case. Specify our service as the Qiskit Runtime service and our backend as the IBM Chasm simulator. We'd run the job by specifying the circuit index we want to run, along with any parameter sets or number of shots. In this example, there is only one circuit corresponding to the index 0, so we put that index into the runtime call. Here we just execute one call and get our results back. Now let's look at multiple circuits. We'll pass in the same bell circuit 3 times, and our call will reference each of them in order, 0, 1, 2. And we have our results. We could have also done this by passing in a single circuit and referencing the index 0 3 times. Now let's try an example with parameters. In this example, we have 2 circuits and 3 sets of parameters. The session is initialized with the 2 real amplitude circuits, and the call references the first circuit twice and the second circuit once, as specified by the circuit indices. However, the first circuit is executed with the parameters theta 1 and then with parameters theta 2, while the second circuit is executed with parameters theta 3. We can see the parameter list must be of equal length to the circuit index list. Note in this example, the circuits do not contain any unbound parameters. But if they did, those parameters would need to be specified in the session constructor and match an index with those of each parameter set. The estimator works similarly, but the outputs are expectation values of quantum observables. So these must be specified as an input to the estimator primitive. We'll create these observables from poly operators, and our circuits will be the real amplitude circuits Psi1 and Psi2. Initialize the runtime session with the estimator primitive, passing the circuits, observables, and service to the context manager. Now we can see the power of making calls to runtimes by constructing a number of expectation values with the estimator. For example, we can construct the expectation value of H1 on the state Psi1 of Theta1 by taking the circuit index 0 corresponding to Psi1 and the observable index 0 corresponding to H1. This will make an estimator call with our parameter values Theta1. Similarly, we can create the expectation value H2 and H3 both on the state Psi1 of Theta1 by referencing circuit indices 0 and 0 corresponding to Psi1, observable indices 1, 2 corresponding to H2 and H3, and parameter values Theta1 for both of them. For brevity, you may not necessarily need to specify the labels circuit indices, observable indices, or parameter values, as long as you put them in the correct order. Here's the expectation value of H1 on the state Psi1 for 2 sets of parameters Theta1 and Theta3. Finally, the expectation values of H1, H2, and H3 on the states Psi1, Psi2, and Psi1, respectively, with the parameter values Theta1, Theta2, and Theta3. In this video, we've learned how to get set up with Qiskit runtimes on both IBM Quantum and IBM Cloud, followed by an overview of the sampler and estimator primitives. Further tutorials are available at qiskit.org and are linked to in the description. Please let us know what you think in the comments, and thanks for watching.